It is quite terrible to see so many patients, I think around 800 now, having palata injuries. And unfortunate, so many numbers we have to see. As a surgeon, we learn to be empathetic and compassionate. We have been taught, trained not to be sympathetic, we have to show empathy. And so that way, even now, so many patients are complicated because they have gone through and through. So we need multiple surgeries. Like yesterday, we have done most of them. Surgery is done in and myself, and also doctor who came, Dr. Glocal. Those patients who developed retina problem again. So we operated again. It's a problem for them. I think we need a team of psychologists to talk to them all the time, saying that we are doing day and night. And then if they grill us, like today morning, I just told them, operated Aisha in Hyderabad, they told, you'll see what is the problem, again there's a problem. I just said, that is why I never answer, what will you see later? I always say it's like writing exam, and then you say, when you write, it will come 2 months later, not before. You can say anything, I have done the surgery there. Vision, when it comes, only patient is the best judge, and he will declare. And second, we have to keep checking 3 months, 6 months, or 1 year. And it's all long term. Many are doing well, so that is the reason we operate. This is a common thing in a retina surgeon's life. When I started in 84, I think the whole thing is nobody wants to operate retina patients or injury patients because it is not vision is not directly proportional to the amount of work we do. So yesterday, the whole day, we all three doctors operating from morning to night, almost 11:30, and still many patients don't see immediately. They take time. Some may require one more surgery. So we have to struggle. You have to be perseverant, persistent. That's why we have 5 P's. Patience, and as a surgeon, precision. Many will need one, and some will need two, and some of them may need 3 or 4 also. These are all young people. The vitreous is attached to the retina like a gum on a silk cloth. So the problem is to remove that blood clot with the highest efficiency and make sure that we don't tear the retina. And the problem is already the bullet has torn the retina. So we have to laser them. So once the retinal tear happens, the cells fall, retinal pigment epithelium cell, which come into the vitreous, and they migrate, and in the process of natural healing, it produces scar. So the scar contracts like this. So the retina is like, as I said, only about 2 millimeter. In that, about 3 millimeter area, is the main for all of us to see the color, vision, reading. So that part should not wrinkle. So to keep that in position, we have to struggle. And that's a normal, we call it PVR, proliferative vitreo retinopathy. And that's the challenge in injury. And that's why all over the world, the injury person, they're expert, they can manage any complication. But still, I think the patient psychology is important. And the one more thing which I feel psychologist's role and even press and everybody's role in the family is just because they're one eye, fortunately 98% are I think only 1 eye injured. No, I think not even maybe more than 99% are 1 eye. Only I think about 20, and in that we are struggling to operate 1 eye. And I, at least whatever I operate, I remember yes, surgically successful. We call it anatomical. Functionally, I think they are seeing something. So I hope because they lost 1 eye. I know it's a psychological trauma, but we have to boost their I'm saying that they can do everything except flying. I think I'm happy the department is well equipped, and even I met CM to request her to equip the other two or three. So we'll have 3 operation theaters which will be well equipped. And also we have already had my daughter's person coming visiting, and she has promised and already called the necessary people to do it. Hey, but it comes with the velocity. So eye is like a tomato. So it goes pierces from the center of the eye, whichever part of the eye, and comes out most of the people. I think more than 90% of gone into the orbit. We call it back orbit. Right? But whichever is inside, we are removing, where we make an incision and remove. And I think when it goes, it produces the tear in the cornea sclera, then injures the lens, and then produces hemorrhage in the back of the eye, then retinal tear, and maybe some patient retinal detachment, and some develop late retinal detachment. And then some have the exit wound, we call it. If it goes to the center of retina called macula, unfortunately, we don't have any way to transplant or regenerate macula or optic nerve. So these two areas we can repair, but we can't make the cells regenerate. So that is what we are waiting, because any retina surgery we do, minimum is 6 weeks. I think many patients are happy, but scientifically we have to analyze that. And then some require recurrent hemorrhage, some has a recurrent retina problem. Those patients we are operating again. So I think we have to see in the long run, 3 to 6 months, how the results improve. And I think many patients have improved from zero to something like 5, 10, 20, and few of them got even almost 100%. A lot of people who have wrote to me, even the last visit, Sahil was after me, why not to operate? But at the beginning, because there was no like perception from the time when she got injury, and plus she had a brain injury, then meningitis, so I was hesitant to operate. Then so many requests came from doctors from the US, from England, and many, I mean, so many people, evaluations are there for us, and they are ready to sponsor, and somebody wrote that our doctor wrote to me directly, I can do a retina transplant, artificial retina, and we will get the funding. The artificial retina is about 2 crore. Yesterday, one hour into a given, the artificial retina is not eligible for any injury patient. It is only for who are blind in both eyes, but due to a disease called retinitis pigmentosa, which we call night blindness. And the second is minimum age is 25 years, and they should be psychologically alright, and also willing to undergo training for vision for 9 months. So we made it clear to everybody involved, the relatives, the press, and the center. We are trying, although we know there's no chance. And she accepted also. And the surgery has gone well, but the bullet has gone, as I told in the electrometer score, they have gone from front, a right of the eye, and the side of the retina also has taken off. So 1/3 of the retina is not there. So whatever was there, and we cleared the flat and put the retina back. I think otherwise, surgically she's doing well. And my neuro is also, she's fine. So I think she wants to go for a checkup too. Right now she's in Bombay. I think now since I have come to Kashmir third time, and all friends keep asking, what is the, how is the security? I tell them, ambulance is the security for me, it's not the security. And second is, I think, I have not seen the exactly what is happening. I should say, I am now believing this secret book which is written by Rhonda Byrne. For the last visit to now, I am changing my statement where, if we keep repeating the truth, that keeps happening. So that's law of attraction. So that book says, people think about what they don't want and attract more of the same. So I want to attract that I am imagining there is peace prevailing and peace is happening. So I think I should stay in the statement. I think one boy with the operated in see the problem of doing retina surgery in an injury is recurrent retinal detachment. Over time, even my own patients have done yesterday. So it cannot be saying that only thing it, like when you hear some other surgeon operated, psychologically it will look better. But anybody does surgery in a PVR, 50% can have problem. So that is why some patients need 3, 4, and 5 surgeries, because you keep on removing scar tissue. Yesterday, we had injected oil previously by various hospitals here and as well as in everywhere, and then we have removed the oil, removed the scar tissue, again re-injected oil. So it looks like a mechanic repairing the car, but we have to struggle there. Because in the eye, the natural healing produces scar, and the scar produces a recurrent detachment and makes the retina thick and more thicker. That's why you have to time the surgery, neither too early nor too late, in between we are doing. And that's how I have suggested to them that you do the surgery as early as possible. Whichever patient you feel complicated, keep it for me, I'll come and do it. It is frustrating, and I have to motivate myself. Yesterday was very, very frustrating because every day surgery was tough. But yesterday morning when I saw all patients are doing well, at least anatomically we are happy. But so here are two parts, no? One is our success, second is patient's success. He wants only normal vision, which is where we have to train them. They have to keep on giving us blessing, that even if they give 1%, 10%, 20%, I think they have to sincerely pray from the heart, saying that we are doing the best and God give us more, instead of asking us. No, they keep on asking. I'm not telling they should not ask, but in that anxiety, they don't understand. Hundreds of patients we have to talk and do. So we are also human beings, and I'm not telling you won't discuss, but I think overall they should know that with the faith only, I mean the department is calling me, and same faith with the experience I'm operating.